Shasha.
Hi.
Welcome to V Entertainment. This is your first time, right?
Yes, it is.
So what's it like being Shasha right now? Because your life has changed over the last couple of months. Can you imagine?
It's been, I won't lie, it's been so exciting. It's been exciting, it's been overwhelming because it's all so new to me. So it's just like, it's just, everything is just coming so fast. And it's like, okay, well, I'm just going with it, I'm going in. And I mean, it's been such an amazing experience.
Yeah. But they always say it takes like a few years to have that 1 year that changes your life. So just give us a very brief history. Who are you? How did you get into the music industry?
Okay, so I started back at home. I'm Zimbabwean, I'm from Zim. So I started back at home and I mean, I started this whole thing like 6 years ago. So yeah, so basically I started back at home, worked my way out here. And thank goodness my team came and got a couple of producers I could work with out here. In the midst of all of that, I meet my Maporisa through my cab driver.
Wow.
Yeah, and then from there, I mean, like from that point, we just started working. Studio time, and that was in 2017. So there was a whole lot of studio time, and that's how I ended up on Lindo's album and working with Don Laka and Emma Fard and all these hits, Aglalegi and all these songs that are coming out now.
Babe, so you had that American dream, but the South African dream. Like, it's just like, move to South Africa and all my dreams will come true. That is so amazing. Yeah. Well, we are so glad that you have decided to call South Africa home. We thank you for music. And thank you for showing our industry love, man. Talk to us about the journey, man, because it's been lots of high highs and lots of low lows, but now it's 2020. Where are we at with MoFire?
Yeah, thank you very much. I think it's, as you're saying, a South African dream. You know, I look at the likes of Ushasha, I look at Sebi. I remember when Sebi came into the business. I remember when you came into the business. Our stories are all similar. In the beginning, people doubt you. In the beginning, you might sort of doubt yourself a little bit as well, but it's about just having that push, you know, having that prayer and believing in yourself and believing that I can make it happen. I believe in myself. It's not easy. The journey does become tough at times. You do get a bit lonely. Entrepreneurship as well. And I look at all of us as entrepreneurs because, we're independent contractors. Nobody's got a pension fund payout yet. You know?
True.
We got to all plan our futures. Yeah. But the brand has grown. The brand is amazing. The brand is at all the mass cash outlets nationwide. And that's incredible achievement for us. The brand is at all the Pick and Pay Express stores with the BP filling stations nationwide. The brand is at all the... it's on Take A Lot, which is amazing for a lot of people who don't want to go and shop. They can just, you know, click on their phones and it's delivered at their doors. But it just says, any South African child out there, an entertainer, whatever business you're in, just believe in your dream and just go for it. Watching Zozi do her thing last year, watching the rugby team do their thing last year, watching Black Coffee, watching Trevor Noah, watching some of the guys that were working with Beyonce, it's a similar story. It's a South African story.
Gyroscophobia. Am I saying it right?
I remember we once spoke about it on the show.
Gyroscophobia, yes.
Yeah.
Apparently you've got it. You don't.
Oh no, this I found out it's a fear of getting old.
Oh,
wow,
yeah.
Come on,
I think I got
I
that.
I swear. Yeah.
Wow.
We spoke about it on the radio the other day and it was just the idea of turning 30. You know, it's like the 20s have been so amazing, and now this form of expectation, we're talking about it right now when you turn 30. And I remember checking out Gary V's videos, and Gary V was like, bro, stop putting time, you know, as a determining factor of everything. Just do you, live, make memories. If you think you're failing in your 20s, trust me, some people popped in their 40s. So just live. So now I'm more excited about, you know, turning 30. But at the same time, back of the head, I'm like, I'm taking a new bracket now.
Hey, I can imagine that. That's pretty wild.
But it's blessed, though. He's turning 30 in 2020.
Woo! That's epic.
That's really awesome.
That's really, really awesome. Blessings all the way.